Whenever a patient or family comes to us with the diagnosis or suspected diagnosis of osteosarcoma, the first question they ask us is as to what is osteosarcoma? Is this some kind of a cancer of the bones? Sometimes a patient comes to us for second opinion when they have been advised amputation or cutting of the limb as the only surgical option for its treatment. So whether a limb-saving surgery is possible is another very common question. And the most important question which almost everyone asks me is whether osteosarcoma is curable. Hello everyone, welcome to Bone Cancer Clinic Chandigarh, an exclusive orthopedic oncology clinic of North India. I am Dr. Rajat Gupta, orthopedic oncologist. And in this video, I'll be talking about the most frequently asked questions on osteosarcoma, like what causes osteosarcoma, what are the symptoms of osteosarcoma, what are the various treatment options for osteosarcoma, and the most important question, what are the chances of cure if someone has been diagnosed with osteosarcoma. For more information, appointments and queries, you can also WhatsApp at 99303-72264 or visit our website www.curebonecancer.com. Coming to the first question as to what is osteosarcoma, well, it is a kind of bone cancer in which the bone cells start growing out of control and produce immature bone. This being a cancer has a tendency to spread to other parts of the body. Coming to another important question as to what are the symptoms of osteosarcoma? Well, the most common symptom is pain, which may not be constant initially, but gradually progresses to a continuous dull aching pain. If it occurs in any of the bone of the lower limb, patient may experience difficulty in walking normally or may limp while walking. Along with pain, there may be swelling around the involved bone which keeps on increasing with time. It's commonly seen in children and adolescents. These symptoms of pain, etc., may be attributed to any possible trauma while playing, which in turn causes delay in seeking medical help, which may be detrimental. Since the bone involved with osteosarcoma tends to be weaker than the normal bone, it may not be able to handle the normal stresses like body weight for the lower limb and hence can fracture without any trauma or minimal trauma like fall from bicycle, being hit by football, etc. This kind of fracture is called pathological fracture. Just to show you one example, this was the x-ray of 50-year-old gentleman who had been diagnosed with osteosarcoma of the thigh bone, who somehow ignored his symptoms initially, and by the time he presented to us, he already had developed a pathological fracture. Another common question is, why is it that osteosarcoma has happened to me or my loved one? Well, as of now, there are no known causal factors which cause osteosarcoma in majority of the patients. However, there are certain patients who are at higher risk for developing osteosarcoma, which include patients who have received prior radiation therapy for any other cancer or patients who have any pre-existing bone disease like Paget's disease, fibrous dysplasia, or some genetic syndromes like Reed-Fermoni syndrome, retinoblastoma, etc. Next question is, once we have suspicion of osteosarcoma of the bone, how do we diagnose it? Well, the first and the most important investigation for the diagnosis of osteosarcoma is a plain X-ray, which tells us about the extent of bony destruction, type of bony destruction, etc. In addition, it also tells us about any obvious or impending fracture. After X-ray, a patient is subjected to the MRI of the whole bone so as to look for the extent of the lesion, the involvement of the surrounding muscles, nerves, blood vessels, etc. In addition, MRI also helps us in planning the biopsy or definitive surgery for the patient. Since osteosarcoma can spread to other parts of the body, we need a PET CT scan to scan the whole body. It's a single test to look for disease anywhere else in the body. In addition, PET CT also helps us in the assessment of response to any treatment like chemotherapy, etc., given to the patient. The most important investigation in the diagnosis of osteosarcoma is biopsy, in which part of the abnormal bone is taken and is sent for testing under the microscope by the pathologist. This process of taking abnormal bone can be done with the help of an open surgery, which requires incision and stitches and is called open biopsy. However, a more convenient and patient-friendly way to obtain this abnormal tissue is with the help of a needle, and it's called needle biopsy. As compared to open biopsy, needle biopsy has the advantage of avoiding any major incision, and hence it causes no or very minimal pain. In addition, a needle biopsy can be done as a daycare procedure, and hence it avoids hospitalization. And the most important benefit, which has an impact on oncological outcome as well, is that needle biopsy causes much less contamination of the normal tissue as compared to open biopsy. We need to understand that incision at the time of final surgery depends on the previous biopsy scar, since biopsy scar needs to be removed at the time of final surgery. Now if we see, this is the open biopsy scar, and this will be our incision at the time of final surgery, ellipsing the biopsy scar. And you can see the extent of skin loss at the time of definitive surgery. Vis-a-vis, if we see the needle biopsy scar, this will be our incision, and you can see the extent of skin loss with the needle biopsy scar, which is much less. Now, if we compare the amount of skin and muscle loss with open biopsy to that of needle biopsy, we can see the extent of skin loss with needle biopsy is much less. This has an implication at the time of final surgery, since greater skin loss means patient may require some sort of plastic surgery in the form of flap or skin graft at the time of final surgery. Just to show you a case example, this was a patient where open biopsy was done, and you can see this was our incision at the time of definitive surgery, and we can see the amount of skin which needs to be removed at the time of final surgery. If we compare the needle biopsy scar at a similar site, we can see the amount of skin which was removed is much lesser. However, there are few myths associated with needle biopsy. Some people tend to confuse that FNSE and needle biopsy are the same investigations, since both are done with the help of a needle. However, FNSE and needle biopsy, they are two entirely different investigations, and FNSE does not have any role in the diagnosis of osteosarcoma. Once the diagnosis of osteosarcoma has been made, the next question which pops up is as to how is this treated. Well, management of osteosarcoma is a team approach which requires a medical or a pediatric oncologist who gives chemotherapy and an orthopedic oncologist who does the surgery. So the usual treatment plan for osteosarcoma is as follows. Patient is given chemotherapy for 2 to 3 cycles, which is called neoadjuvant chemotherapy, followed by surgery, which is usually a limb saving surgery, which is followed again by chemotherapy called as adjuvant chemotherapy for additional 3 to 4 cycles. However, some low grade osteosarcoma like paraosteosarcoma can be cured with surgery alone. Next question is, what is chemotherapy? Well, chemotherapy is basically a combination of high-end drugs to kill cancer cells given by IV infusion via veins. Course of chemotherapy is made of several cycles. Each cycle has a treatment period when patient is given these drugs followed by a rest period so that the body recovers from the side effects of chemotherapy. And once the rest period is over, patient is started on chemo again. The common drugs used for chemotherapy in osteosarcoma are adriamycin, cisplatin, methotrexate and ifosfamide, with adriamycin being the backbone of any chemotherapy regimen. Although there are number of chemotherapy regimens recommended for treatment of osteosarcoma, but it has been proved that chemotherapy regimens which has three drugs have a better survival and success rates than two drug regimens. Another big question is, what kind of surgery is performed in osteosarcoma? Till few decades ago, the only surgical option for treatment of osteosarcoma or any primary bone cancer was amputation or cutting of the limb which had the cancerous bone, which resulted in permanent disability and handicap. However, with the current advanced surgical techniques, it is possible to remove only the cancerous bone without cutting the limb, and it is called limb salvage surgery. So what exactly is limb salvage surgery in osteosarcoma? In limb salvage surgery, we remove the cancerous bone, which is shown in red here, without cutting the limb, and the defect so formed, which is shown in yellow, is reconstructed with the help of an artificial implant called as megaprosthesis. Just to show you few case examples, this was the x-ray of a 25-year-old lady with osteosarcoma of the thigh bone, that is distal femur. After neoadjuvant chemotherapy, she underwent limb salvage surgery with megaprosthesis, and this is her function at 6 months. She is able to walk normally and fully bend and straighten her knee. At the end of 1 year, she is able to carry out all her routine activities like walking, climbing stairs, etc. easily. Another case example of a 45-year-old male with osteosarcoma of the hip bone, who was given neoadjuvant chemotherapy and then he underwent limb salvage surgery with megaprosthesis. This is her functional status at 9 months. He is able to drive his car, walk normally, and carry out all his daily routine activities easily. However, some patients do not require megaprosthesis for reconstruction. In those, the cancerous bone is removed and is exposed to high dose of radiation therapy, which kills the cancer cells, and once sterilized, it's re-implanted back to the parent bone. This technique of re-implanting back the cancerous bone after sterilizing with high dose of radiation is called ECRT technique, which stands for extracorporeal radiation therapy. Showing a case example of 16-year-old boy with osteosarcoma of the shin bone treated with ECRT. And this is his functional status at the end of 2 years, where he can walk, run and climb stairs without any difficulty. You can click on the link above to see his story, how this boy successfully conquered osteosarcoma. Apart from ECRT technique, even cryotherapy can be used to sterilize the cancerous bone. In this, the cancerous bone is dipped into liquid nitrogen, which has a temperature of -196 degrees centigrade, and freezing at such cold temperature kills the cancer cells. Just to show you how it's done, the cancerous bone is removed and dipped into liquid nitrogen, which has a temperature of -196 degrees centigrade. This low temperature kills all living cells, including the cancer cells. Once sterilized, the bone is grafted back to the parent bone. This technique is called cryotherapy technique. Just to show you a case example where we utilized cryotherapy technique for limb salvage surgery. This was the x-ray of 18-year-old boy with osteosarcoma of the ankle bone, that is distal tibia, who was advised amputation or cutting of the leg at multiple centers elsewhere. This is how his x-ray looks post limb salvage surgery with cryotherapy technique. And this is his function at 1.5 years. You can click on the link above to see his story of how he successfully defeated osteosarcoma. Coming to the most important question, whether osteosarcoma is curable. Well, with the current chemotherapy regimens and advanced surgical techniques, osteogenic sarcoma is curable in majority of the patients, provided the patient reaches the specialist at the right time. Where should one consult when diagnosed with or suspected to have osteogenic sarcoma? Well, since first chance is the best chance when it comes to treating osteosarcomas, one should consult specialist treating in bone and soft tissue cancers, and he is called orthopedic oncologist or musculoskeletal oncologist. I hope most of your queries related to osteosarcoma have been answered by now. For more information, you can also log into our website www.curebonecancer.com. You can also follow us on our Facebook page, Bone Cancer Clinic. For more informational videos on bone cancers, please subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the given link. You can also send your queries via WhatsApp on 99303-72264. Thank you.